Here, I'm going to show you how to generate random dates in Excel. So we hit F9 to recalculate the sheet, and there we go. This is a really great little thing, and it starts using the date function. So with this function, we have three arguments, one for the year, the month, and the day. And you just input a number for that. So let's say 2020, 110, enter, and you have a nice little date. So all that we have to do to get a random date is to use the great randBetween function. And we give that a bottom number. So what's the lowest value that we want to allow it to output? How about 2000? And comma a top number. So the highest value to output, 2020. So this will generate a number from 2000 to 2020, and we use that for the year argument. Now, let's go ahead and I will just delete all of these. For the month, we go rand between 1, 12, close that guy up. And for the days, we go rand between 1, 31. And that is all there is to it. Now, you may be saying, hey, rand between 1 to 31. Well, February does not have 31 days in it. That's going to be a problem. But I'm going to show you why it's not going to be a problem in just a moment. So hit enter and recalculate the sheet, F9. There you go. Now let me show you why it does not matter if the day is a little bit too big. So let's go with February, okay? And we go for 28. All is good. But what if we put 31 here? It simply adds it and goes to the next date. So now we have March 2nd. So we do not ever have to worry about this guy being too big and causing an error. And that's all there is to it. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the little bell icon so you can see all of my new tutorials.